that's C, or if you prefer, really it's C.
When I started teaching, what I imagined teaching physics was professor at the board giving very clear explanations. This kind of teaching, it's predicated on an idea that I could transfer my knowledge to you just by talking.
Right, you have an E-field, and then it's...
My classes today reflect this shift from me being the transmitter of knowledge to them being the generator or creator of their own understanding.
Remind me, how do we get the B-field?
Certainly not a class that's, you know, presented movie style, where you're sitting there and sort of receiving information.
He's really good at leading you with questions and making you arrive at the conclusion yourself rather than just telling you.
Teaching is a huge part of my life. It's, I would say, what gets me up in the morning. I love it, and I get great satisfaction from it, and I also view it as the sort of essential service.
So, question, if the wave is e to the minus I omega t, are you going clockwise or counterclockwise?
Physics is a challenging topic. I think trying to think systematically about how the world works requires allowing nature to speak.
It's almost cripplingly anxious for me to try and work on homework alone. I am sure I'm capable of doing it, but I sit down with a problem set and try to start it by myself, and I'm just like, I don't know this. There's no way I can do this. And then when I work with at least one other person or more, I suddenly am like, oh, well, that's exactly how you would do it.
You need other people there to bounce ideas off of.
I think there's considerable evidence that social interaction between and among students is extremely important for their learning. I've been very lucky. I'm in the right place at the right time. So I'm very interested in both teaching, but also the science or scholarship of teaching. And I'm at a university that values that.
So do it on a piece of paper. Calculate K tilde.
He really helped me like stay on the track. There was my sophomore year, I actually considered dropping the major because I was so demoralized. And then I took a class with him, and I was like, oh, I actually can understand physics, and it's entirely due to him.
One over K imaginary carries within it the distance, it's called the skin depth. It's how rapidly do electromagnetic waves.